Yeah, Pat, Theo Lawson with the Spokesman Review. Kurt Schultz talked about getting someone with a strong fundraising background. Obviously, it's something you have. How do you plan to tailor that to Washington State and improve that category for Wazoo?
So the question was about fundraising, taking to Washington State. The reality of fundraising is all about people and passion and relationships. The day and a half I've been here spending time with the search committee, I mean, people all across the country know how supportive the Cougar Nation is. So we're gonna go out, we're gonna meet people, we're gonna make sure people understand what exactly is happening at Washington State University, the great things happening under President Schultz's leadership, and really we're gonna ask them to help us. But we're gonna go reach out to our friends and family and let them know that, hey, we had a record-setting fall in athletics. We finished top 25 in the Director's Cup. That's never happened here before. The things we are doing as an athletic program, we are striving to be the best in the Pac-12 and the best in the country in everything we do. And we're gonna need everyone's help to be a part of that. Just listen. I am an outsider here, and I recognize that. So I'm gonna have to learn the lay of the land, learn the people, learn the customs, understand Washington State. I'm fortunate to inherit a wonderful staff. They've been ultra supportive, ultra communicative. We're making plans right now to get out and see the state and talk to a lot of people. So really, it's just get a lay of the land and ultimately get my family settled here eventually. But it's really just to listen and learn and kind of get a better understanding of what Washington State is.
Yes. You bring a lot of experience to the Ohio State University. We can call the Washington State.
I'll leave those decisions to Phil and President Schultz. They handle all the branding for the institution.
Dylan Howe from Coug Fan. You mentioned that the sports programs over the fall did very well. What were some of the other areas that sparked your interest in coming to WSU?
So the question was, what else sparked my interest? The reputation of this place is incredible. So that's one piece of it. Two, and I know how humble he is, President Schultz's reputation in college athletics is impeccable. And the reality is, for an athletic director and an athletics program, when you have a transformative leader as a president, you can do some extraordinary things. So I believe everything is in place right now. Bill Moose left this, I mean, walking through these facilities, I mean, this place is incredible. And you see the people that we've accumulated here, the president that we have, the passion of our alumni base, we're in great shape. So it's my job to make sure that this next chapter of our athletic program's history is the greatest one ever written. Our team is gonna come together and we're gonna take our responsibility and write that chapter like it's supposed to be written.
Have you spoken to Bill Moose yet, or do you plan to discuss strategy or his experience of having this job?
We've been playing a vicious game of phone tag, so he was at NCAA meetings last week, but we will connect. I mean, he's got, you know, I know he invested his heart and soul into this place, and, the good thing about our industry is people want to help, so I look forward to connecting with Bill.
Have you had the chance to sit down or speak with each coach here program-wise on campus athletically?
I'm trying to get them to like me. So I did some phone calls right when I snuck into town last week, went to a women's basketball game, saw Bobby Buckets drop a bunch of points on the Huskies. So I've just done a couple phone calls. I caught Coach Leach yesterday because I thought he was going to go out on the road recruiting, so I got to spend some time with him yesterday. But I'll be here for good the first week of February, so I'm going to spend some quality time with our coaches, get to know them, see what their goals are and what we can do to assist them to help them achieve them.
Any other questions from the room?
Yeah, we should have that all finalized today. One of the things, though, that we decided to do with Pat's contract that's a little different than some athletic director contracts is we kept it much simpler. So Pat's base salary would be $650,000 a year, and we only put one incentive really in the contract, and that is surrounding fundraising. So he and I will agree on a fundraising target and how that's going to look, and we'll put it out. This won't be a secret. And he can earn another $25,000 a year based on achieving that fundraising success. We also then put on top of that a $25,000 a year incentive to retention bonus that's payable at the end of a five-year contract. So, you know, the rest of the contract's got the other stuff about courtesy car and tickets and some of the standard things. But Bill Moose's contract was, when it was done, that was very similar in time as a lower base and then lots and lots of incentives. And I just felt, to be fiscally transparent, this was really a better way to go as a higher base salary, but then not have nearly as much incentives. And I think that illustrates when we did the AD search, I mentioned that we needed to bring in a person that had great fundraising background, because I still think we have great coaches, great student athletes, terrific facilities, lots of faculty and staff support. The financial part is where we need most of our effort, and Pat brings that to the table, and that's what we want to incentivize. We will make the contract available as soon as it's all signed and executed to the media. So we're just going to start doing that on a regular basis so everybody can look and digest the 20 pages of stuff that's there. So,
all right, any other questions?
I'll
move.
Oh,
yes, sorry.
The question was, am I looking to make any immediate changes to the athletic department? No. I'm going to come in and, like I said, just listen and learn. You know, there's wonderful people here. It's amazing to see this community rally around what happened last week. It's reassuring to know that we have great professionals and coaches that are here serving you, our student athletes. So, like I said, I'm just trying to learn, listen, and get you guys, get the student athletes and the coaching staff and the staff to like me, and we're going to build some trust. We're going to spend some time together, and we're going to try to do some great things for Washington State. We, our responsibility is you and your peers to make sure you get a transformative experience. And I know I'm dealing with John and Ann and Thad and Matt and the whole team. I mean, everybody is committed to you guys, and you know, we have one shot at your college career, and we want to make sure you get the most out of it.
As we hire VPs, one of the things that I've asked our vice presidents to do is to not come in the first 2 weeks and do all this kind of shuffling around and turnover and things like that. I think you've got to be somewhere for some period of time and get to know not just the culture of a place, but the people, their backgrounds, what types of things that they're doing before you start shuffling things around. And so if I look at our last several vice president hires, almost all of them done exactly the same thing. Give themselves 6 months or a year to really get to know things before deciding to make any really significant changes. And Pat and I talked a little bit about this as well. Come in and get to know the place. And the good news is, with the way our athletic teams are doing and some of those things, there's nothing that has to happen immediately. So he can come in and really spend the time to get to know us before having to make any sort of decisions or making changes. So.
Ohio State, while you were there, two big programs, kind of the outliers athletically are football and basketball. I mean, do you see WSU as somewhat of a sleeping giant basketball-wise, and how important is it for you to get WSU into the forefront of the Pac-12 and the nation in both sports?
Well, I think it's all sports here. We're looking for comprehensive excellence. We want excellence in everything we do, whether it's sports information, fundraising. For us to accomplish our goals as an athletic department, it's just not two sports. It's not just a couple coaches. It's our entire athletic department coming together for our student athletes and for this university. So we know our coaches know they have to win. That's part of the deal. That's across the board, and there's a lot of pressure on them. That's why they're a tough job. So we just got to make sure that our coaches feel supported, all are supported. But I know this, and coming from President Schultz, this community here is all in behind Washington State University. And when you're at a place where everyone is all in behind you, you can do some pretty special things.
Let's move to calls or questions from folks on the telephone. Anyone on the phone would like to ask a question?
I have something wrong with the yellow pants. It didn't really hear too well, but one question for you. Dealing with Coach Tiffany, he's obviously sort of a character, you know, kind of says whatever's on his mind. How has sort of your experience with him, you think, helped prepare you to work with a guy like Coach Nietzsche with similar characteristics?
Well, every coach is different. I've worked with a vast array of coaches throughout my career, and I learned a lot from Lane. I think we all take great pride in what he did at Florida Atlantic University. The environment was there for him to have the best year of his entire career. You know, he came in with a vision for our football program there, and he executed on it. So I know in spending time with Coach Leach, he has a vision on what he wants to do, and he knows, he's so proud of this place and so proud of all the people behind him and the student athletes and the recruiting class he has coming in, the facilities we have. So my leadership style is more adaptive to who the person is, and we just want to make sure that Coach Leach and his assistant coaches have what they need to be successful. But in talking with Coach Leach, he's in a great place with Washington State.
Other questions from the phone? All right. Well, we'll have an opportunity for one-on-one. Pat, if you'd like your family to join you, we can
take a family photo. Thank you, Go Cougs.